Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Talking about pivot tables this week, let's create a quick pivot table with dates going down the left-hand side. So, insert pivot table and OK. I'll choose the date field that goes down the left and the revenue field. Well, you know, because we started out with transactional data, of course, we get a report that shows daily dates going down the left-hand side. It'd be nice if we could group that up to months or quarters or years. Very easy to do. We go to the first date field. I can either right-click here or now just up in the ribbon, I'll choose group selection. And I get a great dialog box that allows me to say, maybe I want to show the information by months, quarters, and years. We'll click OK, and instantly Excel has taken those daily dates and has modified it to show us years, quarters, and months. And I want to look down here in the row labels area. You see that it's actually three separate fields. So we can take the years field now and move it across to column labels, and we can now see a year over year comparison of 2007 versus 2008 very quickly using the grouping options within the pivot table. Now, one question that comes up, there's really no setting there for weeks. Let's take a look. First of all, I'm going to ungroup and we go back to daily dates. If we group the selection, if we would choose only days from this drop down, notice the number of days button. This becomes enabled and we can group it up to 7 days. And now we have weekly periods. This is also great if you have 13 months in your year, the 28-day accounting periods, you can group it up by 28 and create those accounting periods. So, some cool options there. And besides the usual months, quarters, and years, you can also basically create weeks or any other strange, you know, 5-day periods or whatever you would ever need to do. Well, hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.